been baptized in the water. Oh, I've been baptized in the water.
Okay, guys, welcome back. The video before this one, if you haven't seen that one, that's part one. You go back and see that one. That's the one that that brought us to Christ Fellowship, and we said yes. I was going to say that our first yes, but no, there's been many of yeses. But
there are many of yeses that led to that yes.
Yes, but in this particular yes, it was what first took us to visit Christ Fellowship. So today we're going to be talking about when we made Christ Fellowship our home. But the important part about it, because this is not about Christ Fellowship, it's about saying yes to what the Lord is telling us to do, but the counting of the cost, the importance. And honestly, I don't even think we even understood what that meant until we actually started counting the cost. Some water. Today's video is sponsored by water.
You should drink some. Mm-hmm.
I think I'm going to start with the Bethel trip. So it's probably not relevant, but, you know, the revival started at Christ Fellowship in 2018. I'm going to say it is relevant because,
it's very relevant.
Yeah, everything that God does is relevant. But in 2018, before we were aware of Christ Fellowship, I had an opportunity to go to Bethel School of Worship for two weeks worship school in Redding, California. Now, I own a DJ company, so the fact of having the availability was a miracle on its own. You know, our first miracle that ever took place then, because I was busy every single weekend, and it happened to be where I had two weeks in a row available. I went.
Which never happened.
Never happened. I took that journey, which was a big deal to take a journey like that. I stay home with the kids normally, so we had to kind of work that stuff out, and it worked out great. So just to kind of skip forward a little bit, you know, I remember coming back, and it really shook me. There was a lot of things that took place there that, it was great. It wasn't like, you know, it was a great move of God, but it was just something that was stirring. I think it was because of the more. That's probably where it began. The Lord was showing there's more. So I remember coming back and being a little bit more attentive to things around me and what God was, because he's always speaking. He's always moving. So I remember that. And I would say it took about a year. Well, maybe in the middle of that was when I remember being at the church we were at before. It was just us, and I remember being in Shrine 4, it was leading worship. We were watching one of the videos from Bethel, and I just felt in my spirit that it was time to hang it up, hang up the DJ company. And really what came to me was it was time to focus on what's been inside me for so long. It's time to get back to the focus on that, and they were leading worship. And that's all I knew was he was leading worship. We've always been in ministry, but it was like, that's the only thing you're looking at, which meant it was time to hang up the detail. You want to share your feelings on that?
Well, let me just... So, the DJ company was very, very good for us financially. Yeah. It was very successful. The Lord... I would say just really, he really blessed it. Mm-hmm. And because it was just so, it did really well for us financially. So I'm the financial person. And so when he came and he said, hey, it's time for me to stop DJing, like, it took me a little bit to get to where I could go, okay, God, you're our source, you're our provider. It's not the DJ company, because, you know, it did add weight to me financially. And now that I was a sole provider is income, for our family. So, it took me a little bit to be okay, with him not DJing, in all transparency, that's just where I was. And so it took me a little bit to get okay with that. It wasn't like he came to me and said, hey, I'm going to stop DJing. I'm like, great, sounds good. Yeah. Let's do it. You know, like I was like, wait, you want to do what? but, you know, this is how the Lord works. He stirred it in Wes, and then he started moving in me, where it was really kind of like, do you trust me? Do you trust me? Do you trust your husband? You know, like, and so then I just had to get to the point. I feel like I got to the point where I was like, okay, if you really feel like this is what the Lord's telling you to do, let's do it.
Yeah. Well, let's, I mean, I just feel like I'm going to go this direction. I think one thing that helps with that is because we've always dreamed together. And I think when you always dream together, you're always saying it's not about whether or not somebody's dream is stupid or better than the other. You will eventually come across something that's actually from God. And I think that's just it. We've been doing that for so long, is even if it doesn't always make sense, you're always doing that. So you're not going to be caught off guard all the time.
Well, and I think too, what helps, you know, picking back off the dreaming together. So Wes and I have always, I mean, times of through dating and all that stuff, we would get in the car and drive around. Like it was like that was like our peace. That was our time to talk and communicate and all that stuff. And so we literally would just get in the car and just drive and just talk. Mm-hmm. And whatever topic came up at the time, whatever was on our hearts, that's just what it was. No judgment of, well, that's stupid. Why would you think that? Or anything like that. It was just like, let's just drive and let's talk it out. Okay, you have that on your heart. Let's like, what does that really look like big picture wise? And through times of just kind of driving and dreaming together like that, having these conversations like that, it had come up before of what if we didn't DJ anymore?
Yeah.
You know, and so I think my heart was somewhat prepared for the fact that he's going to come home at some time and tell me he's done. Because we had kind of already touched on that a little bit. So when he came and said it, the Lord said it's time. I was not, I mean, I'll be very, very honest. I was not like okay at the moment with that, but the Lord was able, I think, because he had prepared me a while before that this might happen.
Yeah.
And the end of the DJ company will come at some point in time.
Yeah. I remember coming from a wedding and loading my equipment in the trailer. And I remember saying, man, it's going to be really cool if that day ever comes to where I'm loading this stuff because we just got done with a ministry.
Yeah.
I remember that. So yeah. I was thinking musically because that's what, you know, I mean, that's what we do still now. But we didn't have any concept of anything past that, you know. But I just, I wanted to go into that because we do dream together. And we talk about we've been doing, I mean, definitely before while we were dating, but I would say more heavily when Reese was born, and we just talked about probably before that because we were talking about traveling and stuff, and we didn't even know what that meant. We just he was already placing things inside of us, and you're looking at a 10-year, I guess, 10-year of, bam, where we're at now. But anyway, but going back to that trip with Bethel and then kind of shutting things down. We were not introduced to anything at Christ Fellowship yet. It was nothing about quitting this to do this. We didn't have all of that stuff there. And the Lord was showing in this time as well that it was more.
Yeah.
And it's what eventually led us to resign from the church that we were at then. Because we were being stirred up. There's more. We didn't know what the more was. Yes, we made that trip to Christ Fellowship. It wasn't about that, but it did bring an awakening of even more of the more that eventually led us to that. And we did end up going on this kind of a 5-week moment, this time. Some people call it sabbatical, but we went at our church. We took those 5 weeks off, and we
We did not call it a sabbatical.
It wasn't a sabbatical.
We called it our season of yes.
Yes, which is so funny because that has been the theme, because that's really what it's all about. And that's not that's scripturally anyway. Just say yes and be obedient to the Lord. But that's what we said. We will say yes. In fact, one of those, which was another pivotal part of this journey anyway, is one of those yeses was there was going to be a prophetic conference in Augusta, Georgia. That I was going to go to, and I didn't make it due to some car issues. And next thing you know, God gives a prophetic word to my mother, who was there, gives them a word. It just goes to show that when God is trying to, he's got things to release to you. It's going to get to you. And I still have that recording. Maybe I'll even be able to pop it on this video of him giving a word. And it was a lot to do with the journey that we were on. And it was the decision was very important that I make the decision, and I make it with wisdom. Because the reality at that moment, I probably wouldn't have made it out of wisdom, even if it would have been the right thing he was telling us to do to leave where we were going. It wouldn't have been out of wisdom. So anyway, so then during that time was us going to Christ Fellowship, bringing the youth from the church there to kind of show them the more. And we just spent the next 4 weeks going there. And it was like every week it was like the conversation that we would have on the way there, he would share it, you know, on Sunday morning, his message. It was just constantly, I'm like, what in the world? Till eventually we said, this is where we're supposed to be. So this is the counting of the cost. I remember we were at the campsite, the same campsite of our story with Levi, and the kids were playing in the lake. And I remember us talking about things that we should cut financially to be able to. The cost is also a financial cost,
right.
But it's not always a financial cost. But in this particular conversation, it was financially. How often can we come up here? We were thinking it might just be like every other week, because, you know, so we didn't have a whole lot of things we paid for anyway, but internet, that's one. We were like, that's $100 right there. Let's cut that. That's gas alone.
Right.
And I remember doing all that stuff. And so we were already having that conversation of what it was going to take for us. And what's so funny is that never happened to where we only went up
every other week.
That never happened. Just saying, we were didn't want to miss anything, so we went every week. That never, you know. So that was the beginning of our counting the cost and starting to really understand what that meant, because we had already did all that stuff. But we say, no matter what, we're going to say yes.
Yeah.
No matter what, and I'm not going to go into this, but there's going to be another video of the segue into when he sends us really on our what activated us. But I believe if you notice a theme here, you know Jess is talking about her, you know, when the Lord sent us to Christ Fellowship the first time, you know, and they got baptized, is paying attention to the promptings, paying attention to when he's stirring and he's moving. You don't pay attention to that stuff, you're going to miss out a lot. Just listen and pay attention when you hear that, like, just respond to it. And that's just little things like that. And your yes becomes a little bit, I guess, clearer sometimes, or what you're hearing him saying, as you're just listening and you're paying attention. And then when you start counting the cost, when he starts revealing more things to us of what he's asking you, I don't want to use the word, it's like yes becomes easier. In a way, it does, because you've already counted. When people are like, man, how are you still going 2.5 hours? And that's on Sundays. If I went on a Wednesday, you're looking at 3.5 to 4 sometimes. How are you still doing that after 5 years? Well, the reality of it is, I think because we counted it a long time ago. We had already had those moments of whatever it takes. And and this is what's going to lead into the next video, which is we said wherever, say, Pastor Todd and Pastor Cam's going to be, if we can help them in any way, we're going to. So there was that moment there, because we had already counted it beforehand. We had already said, if we're available, we're going to go.
Well, and I think, too, you know, when you talk about counting the cost for the Lord, like for us to go to church where we go to church, you know, we had to count the financial cost. We had to budget out going to church. Who has to budget how are we going to get to church? Mm-hmm. You know, but that's literally what we had to do to make this decision. But then when we gave the Lord our yes, and we gave, you know, we said, okay, everything is yours, you know, then it became a, well, the cost is a little bit easier because this is where he's called us to be. This is where he wants us to be. He's going to provide that for us financially. And then there's the cost that we encountered and that we met, which was, you know, we didn't want to just be at a church in revival. We wanted to personally be in revival at a church in revival. And so that was another cost for us that, you know, we really had to die, mm-hmm. you know, like all of us, all of our flesh had to die off because that's what made the yes easier to say yes to.
You're tired all the time because, you know, for us, we have to count the fact that we're going to leave whenever we felt like leaving, which was still watching the baptisms and getting home at 1-2 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Yeah. You got the morning time too.
Our Sundays, you know, our Sundays start at, well, we get up at 5:30 in the morning mm-hmm. to be on the road no later than 6:30. If we're on the road later than 6:30, we're late. So we can't hit the road any later than 6:30. And then we're at church. Then we're in revival. And so then, yeah, our Sundays are 6:30 in the morning to 1 o'clock in the morning, 1:30 in the morning, 2 o'clock in the morning, you know, and that's us and our kids. This isn't just a we counted the cost and it only affects Wes and I. This is we counted the cost for our family. And so our kids are running the same schedule. Mm-hmm. And they are troopers because mm-hmm. they do it and they love it. And, you know, sometimes they don't love it, but they don't love the up so early in the morning is really our struggle. But it was counting the cost for our whole family, not just ourselves.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay.
So, all right. So check out the next one. What are we doing next?
We're going to find out.
Okay.
Yeah, the next one will be our activation.
Yeah. We're activated. Yeah. So you'll want to watch the next video because you'll want to hear how activation happened for us to realize that God moves in the water in Georgia and other places.
Yeah, and how he was calling us into this. Yeah.
Yeah. So check it out. It's a pretty cool story. We think it's cool anyways. You might not, but we think it's really cool. Yeah. So come back next and check it out.